Hello, friends. Today, the Wastes call us. We're going into Pterodactyl Land. We're getting to the point of the game where my two favorite levels are coming up, Pterodactyl Land and Grunty's Industries. And I know a lot of people are going to say, well, Pterodactyl Land makes sense. It is a fantastic world, very open, huge, lots of secrets. Dinosaurs are cool. But Grunty's Industries? Yeah, I'll talk about that a little bit more once we actually get there. But damn, I do love that level. And I still get lost in it, but it doesn't bother me any because I like it that much. But we'll talk about that more when we get there. For now, let's focus on Pterodactyl Land. There are some fun secrets here and some really great new moves and things. That's one thing I love about this game over, you know, like the original Banjo-Kazooie as well, is that throughout Banjo-Kazooie, you get a handful of moves and then like at the halfway point, you stop getting new stuff. You stop unlocking new things. And that's all well and good because the rest of the game is fantastic after that. All the worlds are really well designed. This game gives you new moves all the way up through to the last world. And I think that's partially because there is backtracking to do. So you go all the way up to the last world, get those moves, and then go back for the things that you missed that you couldn't get without these extra moves. And in a lot of cases, there's like some little like special movements you can do to get certain jiggies and things. Anyway, let's unlock the spring step shoes. This will help us get that one jiggy behind the freaking waterfall in the second world of the game. We've been like sitting on this jiggy for so long, and there's no way that I know of that you can like just jump to it. I was told in the comments section of the last video that the jiggy that's on that platform way out in the middle of that like cave alcove, that like flooded cave in Jolly Roger's Lagoon, you can get that with just Kazooie if you use the running shoes and do like a special jump where you spin and then flap. And apparently it's really hard to do, but apparently you can do that. This is something I thought I'd point out. Thank you for sharing your tips and tricks. Keep those coming. I love hearing about that stuff. All right, first and foremost, I am going to, wait, where's the button? The button's up here, isn't it? Oh wait, no, the button's like in a weird spot in this level. Because I really want to open up the train station like first. There's quite a lot to do there. So we'll do that. But first, let's see what this guy's got all about. Oh, shoot.
You never get Jiggy from Rock Nuts Tribe. We've got big, tough armor.
All right. All right, tough guy. All right, tough butt. Try this on for size. Literally. It's tiny. You're a small man. I'm gonna kill you with a small bird. So, I mean, again, we got this in the last video when we got all the most amazing upgrades in the game. Clockwork Kazooie is a favorite of mine. And look, he's got a booty. Look, you can see them cheeks. Them cheeks, though. All right, we're gonna end him.
Arrgh, not fair, found gap in armor. Others not so easy. Still four of us left.
Others not so easy, huh? We'll see about that. Man, we're really going to be seeing lots of Rocknut Butt today. I hope you're prepared for this. I hope you're prepared for this outcome. Lots of Rocknut Butt. Here, well, while we're working our way around the level, let's go up and talk to the Dinosaurs family. See what their issue is. It's the Styracosaurus tribe, I guess. Is that a real dinosaur? These look like Triceratops to me. Is that not accurate? So we got little boy, we got sick, and then here's the mama.
Go away, leave Scrotty alone.
Oh, well, if that's how you greet visitor. Also, Scrotty? Scrody? Like scrotum?
My family isn't keeping too well.
Now you've done it, Banjo. Just wait until you hear all the problems she wants us to fix.
Look at my eldest, Scrat. He's very sickly and needs a doctor urgently.
Which doctor?
I don't care. Any doctor will do.
Honestly, great joke. 10 out of 10.
It's a shaman that lives on the top of a cliff top
that might help.
Scrit here was out walking one day and came back this size. Now he's too small to be a proper dinosaur.
Wow.
Scrut has gone missing. She took some money from my purse and headed off to the train station.
Man, dude, in this economy? So many problems, I told you so, Banjo.
We'll see what we can do.
Wonderful. It's nice to know not every character in this game is bad.
Okay, yeah, you're welcome, Scrotum. We will help you and your family. So we need to heal the sick dinosaur. We need to make the tiny one big somehow. We'll figure that out, I guess. And the missing dinosaur, we already know where she is because we found her in Witchy World. So that's why we need to bring the train here. Ah, Mumbo. This Mumbo pad. Mumbo, why are you telling me about your pad? I don't need to know about that. That's between you and you. All right. Yeah, so this whole level is, again, like, Banjo has this design philosophy of, like, the circular level with, like, a thing in the middle. And not every level in Banjo-Tooie follows the same design philosophy. Most levels of Banjo-Kazooie you'll see are a big circle with, like, a thing in the middle, like the snowman in the middle or the tree in the middle or, you know, whatever. There's a couple levels that deviate from that a bit, but this is one that follows that same design philosophy. Oh, there's the train. So we should be able to just, like, immediately bring the train here, right? Choo-choo. Choo-choo. Y'all know of any good train games? I want to play a train game. I should play Spirit Tracks, honestly. I've been thinking about it. I want to get a new 3DS capture device so that I can stream The Legend of Zelda Spirit Tracks. My old 3DS capture device died on me, unfortunately. So that's no bueno, but. Okay, so Wumba's there. We know we need Mumbo, but we'll probably start. I'll just start with the train station. Let's open this up first, though. Dude, I'm excited for this level. Some of the characters you meet in this level are the most memorable ones in the game, in my opinion. 505 notes out of what, 800? Or 900, I guess, because there's the overworld notes. Out of 900, so what is that? 470, so 495 left to go? No, not even. 395 left to go. Brilliant. That's exciting. All right, let's head back to the beginning. And call upon our Mr. Train, Chuffy the Train. That's the thing. So if I had to criticize anything about Pterodactyl Land, it is a bit cumbersome to get across. I feel like all the worlds that we've gotten, you know, gone through so far have been fairly small outside of Atlantis. But at least Atlantis had, like, I don't know, it's not too difficult to navigate, but there's a lot of verticality to this level too, with lots of little secret tunnels and caves and things to explore, and it's hard to remember which caves go where for a first-time player. I'd like to think that I'll remember everything, but we are at the point in the game where I'm gonna start forgetting things. You're gonna see me do something stupid. I know you are. You're gonna watch it, and you're gonna be like, ugh! And then you're gonna scream at your monitor, and then you're gonna leave an angry comment like, Josh, why did you do it like this? I know this. I have been a YouTuber for 14 years. I know these things. I know what you're gonna say. You're so predictable! Be less predictable! Anyway, Chuffy's here with, what is her name, Scrut? Scrut.
The hell, Bob will be too mad at me.
Do we get to see the, yeah, we do.
Thanks for returning my lost child. She'll be cleaning out our cave for the next month as punishment.
Scooping the family pooping. I get it. Been there. Been there. Actually, no. Honestly, when I was younger, I did not get punished very much. Like, it was very difficult to punish me because I was very stubborn. So, like, my parents would take away a video game console temporarily as, like, a thing to, you know, if I did something bad. And then I would just, like, go and find it and get it. And what are they gonna do? I would go and search it out in the house. I was such a terrible kid. I don't know. How did I become a well-formed adult? One may never know. Yeah, okay, we can do this now. This is pretty easy. Throw out a Kazooie. Do a little cave maze. I'm gonna get lost in here out of time. I know I am. Is this the guy we wanna blow? Yeah, look at them cheeks. I guess I wanted to go get the Jinjo first, because then I don't have to use more than one egg, but here we are. I think it's actually the other way. This is a dead end, yeah. It's actually up. I know, I hear you. Oh, nope, further up. What color Jinjo is this, red? Oh no, this took me down. Oh no. Oh, it's orange. Oh, I don't think I found an orange one yet. Wait, so hold up. Maybe it's over here. Can I go on this one? Wow. Okay. Yeah, that's my first orange Jinjo out of two. Alrighty. Cool beans. Maybe we'll find both orange Jinjos in this level, actually. All right, let's, I'm trying to think of what I want to do next. The thing is that I just have so many options. It would be advantageous to scale the mountain fairly early, but I think I might take care of the rest of the dinosaur family first, since that's a little bit of a longer one. But going up the mountain early is good. There's just so much to do. This level's gonna take a long time. And the things that you have to do too are also a little bit long-winded, which I think maybe turns some people off, these huge levels. I'm just glad, honestly, I'm just glad that you keep your notes, because that was not a thing in the original Banjo-Kazooie. You would have to get all 100 notes in one sitting, or you would have to recollect them in order to get the 100. So I'm just glad that that's not a thing anymore. And also there's not really any penalty to dying either. So like, I don't know, there's just a lot of advantage to, ooh. You know, I think they want me to boots this. Oh no, it's fine. Don't look at me, don't taste me. I don't taste good. Anyway, we got a warp over here anyway, so no biggie. And the Globo. Globo's right next to Mumbo's house. We love that. We love it when there's an easy Globo. I think most of them are pretty easy, but before we go to Mumbo, I think there's a Cheeto page over here. And we are close to another cheat. Actually, somebody on the previous video also commented about potentially using a cheat to help get a Jiggy early in this level. Or like get everything in one area without having to backtrack for it. Unfortunately, and this is something I have not mentioned, I don't think, there are certain cheats that you can unlock that are bonus cheats that you don't get from Cheeto. And then there's ones that you get like super late in the game from Cheeto, but you can actually get early if you do a special method. If you type Cheeto in backwards on the code chamber wall, and then type the name of the code, if you know the name of the code, you can unlock all the cheats early. But if you do that and activate them, it makes it so that your game will not save, unfortunately. So, and that was not a thing in the original. I don't know why they changed it for this. I guess because there's like leaderboards or whatever, which are irrelevant now for this Xbox 360 game. Anyway, it's dumb. It's a dumb change. And one of the things that really turns me off to the Xbox Live version of this game. But that's okay. It's fine. No worries from me. We have Mumbo. Mumbo's a good boy. We're gonna have to come back to Mumbo a couple of times because we sort of need to backtrack a little bit with him. Let's go. What's closest? Probably the world. Oh wait, no, you know what it is? No, hold up. We wanna go back to Mumbo's for a couple reasons. One, because it's actually easier to get to the family's house from here. And two, because I actually need to activate this. All right, you ready? Hope this works. It better, idiot. Enlarge stepping stones. This is an unfortunately provocative little series of platforms here. I don't think that this one was intentional. Rareware is known for putting a lot of like innuendo in their game, but usually that's in the writing and less so in the visuals. This one feels less intentional. But maybe, you never know. It's hard to see, but it does look like a... Well, you can kind of see it from here. It does look like a dick and balls. I'm just saying, it just does, a little bit. I'm just saying, like, I don't make the rules, all right? Oh no, am I stuck? Okay, no, we're good. Dude, Mumbo is so bad. He's slow and he has to stop when he attacks. It's just not ideal, man. Mumbo needs some training. Everybody's like, or Humba's like, oh, who's the better one? Well, no, she thinks she's the better. And Mumbo thinks he's better than her. But she's out here giving me, like, the cool transformations that are even better than the ones that Mumbo gave me in the first game. So, like, I don't know. Mumbo's kind of a downgrade in this game, if you ask me. In the first one, he was sort of this mysterious figure. In this one, he has a lot more personality, but I feel like that takes away from the mysteriousness of him. All right, one of the children is saved. Let's save another one. Hope this works. It better. Oh, what a banger. Yeah. Raise the dino. Oh, yeah. Oh, he's a big boy. Look, he's so happy.
Thanks for beefing up my small child.
What a way to put it.
Perhaps you'll find a girlfriend now.
So this dialogue, I do not remember. Perhaps he'll find a girlfriend now. Ladies, who's looking? Any dinosaur ladies out there? Oh my God. Okay. So that's everything I want to do with Mumbo right now. There's one more thing we can do with him, but we'll have to do it later. So I'll just go to the warp at the beginning here and warp back to Mumbo's house. We'll grab Banjo-Kazooie and I think we're going to start heading up the mountain a little bit because there's a few different, there are three different moves in this world, which is a lot. There's a lot to learn with Banjo-Kazooie separating now. Where am I going? Mumbo skull. Jesus. Gotta take it back to Humbo. Take a little dip in her pool real quick. Yeah, this level gives you some very significant moves, especially some that you need for the backtracking. And we love to see that. And like I've been doing, I'll just go and do the backtracking between worlds, so we won't leave anytime soon. All right. Let me think. What would be the next best thing to do right now? Well, if I wanted to finish helping the family, there's a move that I need to go and get. So let's go do that first. Oh, Jesus. This is probably the most likely world for me to die unintentionally in. Probably the most likely. TBH. Grab these running shoes so we can run across the water. I think there's a Jinjo or like an empty honeycomb, maybe? Yeah, there's an empty honeycomb here. Yoink. East mine. Oh my God! Dude, the second orange Jinjo was here. Let's go. The twins. Look at that! I count it as a free Jiggy, honestly. It feels free. Touch me. Thank you. The orange Jinjo family is complete. Oh, they like it. Oh, they'd like you to have this. What do you mean they'd? When you say we'd like you, it's like you're part of it. We'd like you. Oh, wait, hold up. There's actually another Jinjo I can get immediately that I was not thinking about. You can get this right at the start. I think they actually want you to fly to this, but I'm not gonna do that. Why would I do that? That seems silly. That's a silly goose move. Can I kill you? No, I can only stun. Oh, no, he died. Cool. Oh, no. Can I shoot that with a regular egg? Nah, it's gotta be. The grenades. Okay, cool. So normally, I think they want you to fly to this Jinjo, but we don't have access to fly pads yet, so I'm gonna do it my own way. God, there's so many ways to cheese things with the clockwork eggs. Whoops. This one's a little trickier, especially with this guy respawning. But I think if we aim just right at the wall up there. Hell to the yeah! Cool beans. All right. Dude. See, this is the problem, is that I'm going full ADHD mode on this level because there are so many things. There's not, like, a clear path in my mind. In some of these levels, I have, like, a clear idea of, like, oh, I'm going to do this first, and then this first, and then this. Or then this second, and then this third. In this level, I do not have that. Okay, we're gonna shoot it over his head. Oh! I'm going to run out of these eggs. I'm going to shoot it over his head. Ow, okay. Well, man, he's got the large hitbox, don't he? There we go. Cool. Sometimes if you shoot it a little bit too far, the clockwork Kazooie egg will just blow. Still two of us left. Dude, well, honestly, we'll probably get all of them in this video. What is over there? Oh, it's eggs. Honestly, great time for me to like spend a second to refill on my clockwork Kazooie eggs, because I will be in danger of running out if I'm not careful. And you only get one at a time as opposed to 5 or 10 or whatever it is from the other ones. Okay, so now we've done all that, let's not get distracted again. And we'll go ahead and do, I think it's just through here, right? No, I'll go in there as both of them because I think there's a split head in there. Dude, there's always something behind the waterfall, man. Can't escape these waterfalls. This level, you know what this level reminds me of? This level really reminds me of the first time that I ever experienced Click Clock Wood from the first game. Because that was one of those levels, like you see the painting very early on in Banjo-Kazooie, very early on in Grunty's Lair. And you don't know what it is. You can tell that it's Click Clock Wood because it has the little placard at the bottom of the painting that says Click Clock Wood on it. You're like, what is Click Clock Wood? And then you never experience that until because it's the final world in the game, right? But I got the same feeling experiencing this level for the first time that I did experiencing Click Clock Wood. It was just like a very different feeling level from the rest of the game that felt special in its own way. And I think the last three worlds of this game feel that way. I almost feel like the first four worlds are kind of their own, like they all feel very, very, I don't know, they're all unique though. I can say good things about all the levels, truthfully. Let's not get electrocuted as an idea. Just trying, you know, just workshopping something new. There's the move. I think the split pad's up here somewhere. Yeah, you gotta grab this little ledge. Banjo's got good fingy strength. What does the sign say? You know, I never read the signs, but for a Let's Play, like, I feel like almost obligated to read every sign that I see. Just to see what it says, because I never read these. It's exciting in the Oogle. Wait, what? Oh, it's a hint. It's exciting in the Oogle and Unga caves. What does that mean? That doesn't mean anything. That means I need eggs somewhere. All right, so fun tip. Normally, I think they want you to use Kazooie and Banjo to kill these guys quickly, I guess. Maybe you can throw eggs at them or something. But then you have to get Banjo, or I guess you could just time it right, like lure him out, have him go snap, 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 and then move across. But I'm just gonna show you the easy way, because Banjo has his super special double jump thing that you can do at any time. You can just jump out of the water and get it. You don't have to mess with those snappy guys in the wall. Taxi pack, no Kazooie means space in your pack. A way to fill it is what you lack. Pick large things up off the ground. In they go and carry them around. How they go? Dismissed. So now I got the taxi pack. So I think this is this one, right? You go swoop, and you just go shloop and suck it all up in your backpack. I don't know why he couldn't carry. I mean, how many things is Banjo carrying in his backpack already? You know, how many jiggies is he holding on to? How many feathers and notes does he have all up in his backpack? Even that, like Royston the fish, you just pick him up and put him in the water. I don't know why he couldn't do that before. But now we have a dedicated ability to pick up things, which I think there's only one other thing backtracking-wise that we need that for, but we'll get there. Anyway, what was I saying before I got distracted by getting the move? I was talking about how this level was such a masterful... I don't know, like... Especially because you unlock it so quickly, you know? If you're 100% in the game, which I did, and you're getting all of the jiggies from the first two worlds, you can unlock this, like, immediately. or the first three worlds, I guess. And so you can kind of see it early on. You're like, oh, my God, there's a dinosaur world. And what kid doesn't love dinosaurs, right? Every child loves dinosaurs. I'm a 30-year-old man, and I love dinosaurs. They're just cool. And I feel like this is like, oh, hell yeah. Maybe a little bit of a prerequisite to another rare game involving dinosaurs, Star Fox Adventures, which is a game that I have yet to play all the way through, actually. That's something that I should visit at some point, is Star Fox Adventures. Isn't there a Jinjo here? Or have I gotten all the, I actually think I might have gotten all the Jinjos. Except for one. Hold on. Let me view totals. I just want to see how many Jinjos there are. So I think there's like five per area. Yeah, okay. There are. So there might be a Jinjo around here, but I can't remember. I know one of them is somewhere. it's very detailed. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. There's nothing under the water, right? Like, I keep thinking that there's something under the water here, but I think I'm just crazy. You know what there is under the water? Ancient fish. Look at that. That's kind of cool, actually. Like a nice touch. You know, there's always like fish and stuff in these waters, but like these are like, I don't know. They look ancient to me. I don't know anything about ancient fish. Roar. The sound design is so good in these games too. Ah, there's a Globo. Okay, we're gonna need him real quick. We'll actually take that to Humba immediately. Before we go down there, though, I think it would behoove us to keep working our way down the mountain. I can't go in there yet, I don't think. Well, here, let me go check. If this is a different cave to the one I'm thinking of. No, this is the one I'm thinking of, and I don't need to go here just yet. Actually, I might. I actually might need to go there. I don't know, because I think I needed to jump up. Oh yeah, path to nest. Oh yeah, there's the nest. That's okay, that's not where I want to go yet. I want to do, whoops. Oh, this is my first time using the springy shoes. So this will have to be something I open up later on. But let's do one more thing, because I'm going to get a jiggy, and then we'll probably wrap it up at Humba's house. So we've got this guy. There he is. He's looking this way, and he's going to look at whichever way, because this is a two-ended tunnel, right? So, which is all tunnels. It's a tunnel that goes all the way through the wall. So you sort of have to do these little platforming. Ooh! Such a visceral feeling, just slipping. Fine, it's fine. The Clockwork Kazooie can't feel pain. Do you think Clockwork Kazooie is conscious? Is it a conscious being? Does this look like a conscious child to you? It does, actually. Anyway, time to blow your butthole. Hey!
Not believe you beaten all Rocknut's tribe. We left you. We let you have shiny thing.
Cool. I'm glad that we could come to an agreement, an explosive agreement. So there's that cave too. I think that's the one that I can go in. Maybe, mayhaps, maybe-haps. Ah, yes, Ungabunga's cave. Okay, this is where we'll end off. So you might have reckoned, I don't know if I showed this off at the beginning of the game, but this. Oh, you're gonna recognize this instantaneously. For anybody who does not remember this, here, I'll show you. You might not even recognize this room, but if I go up through here, take a look at where it comes out. Look at that! shit, son! Yo, we're back in Mayhem Temple. We can go right in here. Leave the world, go to Mayhem. Look at that, and they connect together. And then once you, I mean, there are other connections too. So like, there are certain worlds, like you can come through here and go to Mayhem Temple, and then there's another exit in Mayhem Temple that goes to a later world that we haven't even gone to yet. So once you start connecting all the worlds together, it's just really fun to see where all the entrances come out. Any hoozle. Let's split up and we'll end with this, with learning this move. And actually, I think that's all the moves in this world, if we learn this one. This is a big day for move learning, truthfully. Whoopsies. And it's 420 notes. Hell yeah, bro. Hatch, I can't believe that it's your bird. Who can't hatch eggs? It's so absurd, man. Hold down LT or RT and then press X. Then a real bird I'll finally... Sex. C. Sorry, I had to rhyme it. Anyway. We got lots done. We made good progress, I think. Next time, we'll talk to Humble Wumba, and we'll see what the transformation is. Probably one of my favorite in the game, even though it's very underutilized. So come back for that. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you for supporting on Patreon. My name is Josh Jepson, and I will see you in the next one.